distinguished excellencies, organizers, good afternoon or good morning again. I'm privileged to represent His Excellency the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria as his advisor on ethics and values. I also had the audacity of running for the presidency of Nigeria before, even against this same president, but I'm now his advisor on ethics and values. I am also want to stand again as one of the mothers in the house. And my name is Sarah. And I think to the Palestinians and the Israelis, I'm a grandmother to all of you and to all of us in the world. So because my name is Mother of Nations. So allow me to speak from that point of view. But what are we bringing? I'm privileged here because, summarily, we say when people have common values, they are united. We all believe in multiculturalism. That's why we are seated here, and we are listening to one another. And we want to say that when you have common values, you will now behave properly everywhere you are. And that's why we say that ethics is about good character. It's the using of the values to the moral principles for you to live properly with people. So living ethically is the process of multiculturalism. So the summary we have is that multiculturalism is also about multi-ethicism. I want to take this from point of view because, having been a family psychologist, we want to now see, because you're talking of education, you're talking of religion, you're talking of every other aspects of life. But we want to take it basically that we are thinking of now reviving the word ethics, which is almost buried. But I think one of the ways we can think is that we are challenging the United Nations. That in the United Nations Charter, we have good conscience mentioned 4 times. And I raise this issue globally here, that if the United Nations were to prevent all the wars all over the world, they must start with the prevention. Because good character from home, from the family, by civics and moral education, good character in the education, which is also civics and ethics, as well as mentorship, good leadership, starts from good civics, from the family, from the educational process, and your good heart in the fear of the Almighty God to do that which is good. I am a politician, and I believe, and I've been a Christian, I believe I must, as I take oath, to act according to what I was taught from the scriptures. And when I take oath, and what we are simply saying, and I want to very quickly mention this, I have learned in Psalm 2, verse 9, it says, that thou shalt seek to understand righteousness, justice and equity, even the good, and the good all. And it also said in Job 34, verse 30, that let not the hypocrites reign, lest the people are ensnared. And we also learn that when the righteous reign, people rejoice. Because we have analyzed ethics in Nigeria, that ethics is simply good character in the civil or philosophical language. In Christianity, we call it righteousness. In Islam, that's about Sharia. So we don't see any reason why Solomon or Shaibu, Esther or Aisha, should misbehave in any way against their God. And we are, because I have to deal, because my 98% of my family members are Muslims, and I live in the two worlds. And therefore, we have the heart of actually coming up with the good character that you are taught from the books. And when we think so, and I just want to say, well, we are now thinking of raising the national curriculum, which China and Japan did about 200 years ago. You've been working on it. But here in the African countries, we don't know anything much about ethics. The politicians are supposed to learn about ethics. Therefore, last year, from this office, we celebrated the first National Ethics Day. And we are now taking the matter to the United Nations. That it's high time we rose from this meeting, if I would recommend, that this, for multiculturalism, the United Nations must now talk of the preventive measure, the preventive vaccine against hate, against corruption, against all the crimes of capitalism, or anything we're talking about. The United Nations is a good organization that must now begin to celebrate Global Ethics Day or World Ethics Day, because if United Nations can celebrate Dog Bite Day, then it's high time United Nations, all of us, will celebrate it, celebrate the good character of the human species, the good conscience that was mentioned 4 times in the Charter. And that's where we would have seen the United Nations, rather than spend money on buying AK-47 guns, and telling them that we should have prevented these crimes of the mental problems that we are having because of hate and etc. And what we are doing very soon, we're already working. I came for US and I was in UK and I'm also here today. Our ethics for next year's celebration is ethics, the family, a business. Even government is business. Democracy is also a business for people taking care of people. Development, security, and this will mean, and peace. If we don't have this in place, it means that we are just talking patriotic lamentations or diplomatic lamentations. But definitely all of us are parents. And we are thinking of, yes, my brother here, the 34-year-old man, we are concerned, we are all parents and grandparents. How come we are thinking only about the question between the elites and the business and the capitalism? We're not thinking about the future of our civilization. What is the functionality of our civilization if we are coming up with liberality and I beg your pardon. I beg your pardon, the world. We are worried in Africa, the importation, because we don't see a dog man dating a dog to marry a male dog. We have not seen a hen marrying a hen. We are now being lambasted that we don't accept the, is it homosexuality that will not have AIDS? And we're saying this is strange to us. The globalization of this liberality is hurting us. And it also hurts even the dressing of the women all over the world. Because women are now being commercialized. It is unethical for the men to now look at women as sexual objects, not as important mothers of the universe. And therefore, we are asking the women, if we don't teach ethics, we will remain slaves to violations and unethical practices against humanity. The world must also, is ethical to respect the motherhood, because if we don't produce, we don't see your life. No woman production, no population. Well, we must be ethical for a population, and that's why, very quickly, 1 minute before I go, we have this in to make it, because a lot of our people are not educated in the rural areas. So we make it simple for them. This is my job, to explain ethics or what values about commandments or your principles and apply this for accountability of your life, wherever you are, for the standards of excellence we're talking about, or even of this, for the integrity of yourself, what you represent. And but if I represent hate, and then of the goodwill of mankind. So we're asking everybody, what are you bringing to any table? As a Christian, as a Muslim, as a journalist, as a politician, as a Buddhist, and etc. Even as a gay person, what are you bringing to the table to the advantage of the humanity in terms of creating the quality population? And we're thinking of having farms, which is going to teach the people in their rural languages. Every bureau, borough, or local council must have the farms. Food plus ethics, food plus character, plus skills in the communities and the skill centers will make you a functional human being, because we expect you to be an ethical, what you call autonomous morality. It's not, English is not my language, but I have to learn it in order to be an effective mother on the planet Earth. Autonomous morality, please go and check it. But we believe the next revolution we're talking about is ethics revolution. If we surge up the teaching and budget for ethics in our countries, then we will now begin to realize the errors we've made with our civilization. But let the ethics be the revival and the paradigm shift from negative, from confusion, from wars, to peace, to decent living, and also understanding that it's going to result in positive cultural diplomacy. I thank you all for listening to me.